As the 10th anniversary of the September 11th attacks approaches, people in the United States are reflecting on how the event changed them, their country, and the world forever. A U.S. publisher has chosen to memorialize the events by creating a children's coloring book to try and offer kids an explanation of what happened that day. But many are describing this book as offensive. Let's take a look at the cover. It's called We Shall Never Forget 9/11, the Kids' Book of Freedom, and it depicts the Twin Towers burning in this particular image, which I can show you here. Now, it's got a number of other images that people have also found concerning. This next image is one of Osama bin Laden hiding behind one of his wives while a bullet is being shot at him. Nearly all mentions of Muslims in this book are paired with the words extremist, radical, and terrorist. And I want to highlight one. You may not be able to see it clearly on your screen, but it says, "Children, the truth is these terrorist acts were done by freedom-hating, radical, Islamic, Muslim extremists." This has many Muslim Americans arguing that it encourages negative stereotypes of their community. But here's how Wayne Bell, the publisher of Really Big Coloring Books, which is the company behind this controversial book, actually sees it himself. And we're going to give you his words, or at least his view, in his own words.
Hello, my name is Wayne Bell. I am the publisher at Really Big Coloring Books. And I would like to say to the American people and all others who may read this child's coloring book, we shall never forget. The book is designed to be a tool that parents can use to help teach children about the facts surrounding 9/11. This book was created with integrity, honesty, reverence, respect, and the book does not shy away from the truth. Thank you for visiting.
Now, I think this is part of the controversy. People are having different perceptions of what that truth is. Now, Wayne Bell had agreed to come on the show, but he ended up backing out. Joining us now via Skype is Ibrahim Hooper, the National Communications Director for the Council on American-Islamic Relations, known as CARE. Ibrahim, CARE has described this book as, quote, disgusting. Why is that?
Well, I think the main point is that while we do need education about 9/11 and the attacks and the motivation for the attacks and what's happened in the past 10 years, we need something that is objective and accurate. And I don't think, given this target audience being children, I don't think really the target audience has the cognitive ability to differentiate between those who carried out the attack and the faith of Islam itself and the 1.6 billion Muslims worldwide. And I think that was the real intent of the publishers here. This is a group that brings Israeli settlers to the Middle East. It's part of their agenda to smear Islam, to generalize, to stereotype, and to marginalize American Muslims. And, you know, they're free to do it, but we're also free to speak out against it.
Now, Ibrahim, the publisher, Wayne Bell, did state that they reached out to you, that they sent a letter to CARE asking for your input in the creation of the book, and that you never responded.
We often get these letters from Islamophobes saying, will you cooperate with us basically in smearing Islam? And, you know, we don't have a lot of motivation to do that.
Okay. Ahmed?
You know, we have a tweet coming in on this topic. Grace Sani saying, my kids don't learn about 9/11 without learning about the hundreds of thousands of U.S. soldiers, Iraqi and Afghan citizens killed since 9/11. We have a lot of other tweets on the same kind of subject, and I don't want to drive the point too much. I mean, I understand you don't want to participate in smearing Islam, but isn't there something to be said about an organization like CARE perhaps trying to work with some of these groups to correct them before they release this kind of a book?
Well, we work with all kinds of groups all the time, but when it's clear that a group has an agenda, it's really pointless. It's a waste of our time. We'll work with any group of goodwill that wants to offer objective and accurate information, and we have. We've worked with innumerable groups in the past. But when something comes in and it's clear what their intent is, it's really a waste of our time to participate in that kind of effort.
Ibrahim, let me press you a little bit on this point, because I'm looking at the website big coloringbook.com, and I see a book here about the three little pigs, which is a common story many people hear. I see another one about African-American leaders. I see one about dinosaurs. I mean, ostensibly from looking at this website, I don't see any evidence that they potentially started out with a particular perspective. So how did you know upon,
also,
just let me finish the question.
Bit,
let me just finish the question, Ibrahim.
Ibrahim,
if you would just allow me. When you first received the letter from them, Ibrahim, how did you identify upon receipt of the letter that they had an agenda? That's what we want to know.
I'm assuming that whoever they sent the letter to did a little research. On the other hand, you know, a lot of these people just send a letter to whom it may concern, and it gets lost in the mix. I don't even recall receiving it, but let's assume he sent it. You know, but in general, that's how we work with these kinds of things. If it looks like it's something reasonable, we'll work with it. If it looks like it's agenda-driven, we won't.
Shahid, I'd love to get your thoughts on this, because it seems to be, you know, one of these issues when we read the language from the book and it's very clearly negative, but they're claiming that they wanted to reach out.
Well, there's a couple levels I'm looking at this. So first of all, there's kind of the macro level. I mean, we as a country are engaged in efforts in Afghanistan. My wife is going to be deploying to Afghanistan for a year next week. You know, I don't want her safety to be threatened by any sort of incidents that something like this this might cause. And, you know, that goes for all of our servicemen and women overseas. So, you know, yes, this person has a right to do something like this, but they have to take into consideration the larger picture. Now, on the micro level, you know, I just had the conversation with my 9-year-old son about 9/11. You know, the two conversations I dreaded having, the 9/11 one and the birds and the bees one. And, you know, it was really hard to have that discussion with him, you know, in a way that preserved his Muslim identity. It's the type of conversation I would hope to have with any child. And, you know, when I look at something like this, my child wouldn't be able to read this and come away without some sort of really, you know, deep feeling inside that maybe there's something wrong with me. Mm-hmm. And I would hope that something geared toward kids, and frankly, you know, the fact that it's a coloring book means that it's addressed to a very young age, regardless of what they say.
Yeah.
It needs to be able to address it in a way that doesn't leave children feeling angry, upset, or, you know, going out to find my son and beat him up.
Well, so this is something that I think is really interesting in looking at this book, because I just want to highlight my screen once more. And if you see at the bottom of the screen, you see the imagery that we're talking about. If you scroll up, you can see that there's actually a great deal of language. And there are words that are printed relatively small. And I can say from my family, when I look at my daughter's children's books, they have big letters and few of them. And you know, my daughter's very small, so I don't know about older children. But it looks to me in reading this that I wonder if the actual structure of it is truly geared towards children. And Ibrahim, I'm curious to get your thoughts on this. Do you believe that this is perhaps dealing with something more than just an audience of children?
Well, I believe it's geared to indoctrinate children. I believe it's geared to offer a stereotypical portrayal of Islam and Muslims to children so that when they get older, they maintain some sort of hostility to Islam and Muslims. We see hundreds and hundreds of these kinds of efforts. You go on the internet, it's just a cesspool of anti-Muslim hate nowadays. And there's a veritable cottage industry of hate mongers promoting this kind of stuff. Look at the language in the book. They did it because they hate our freedom. You know, that old line. It's just one of those many, many agenda-driven efforts to stereotype Islam and to marginalize Muslims.
Ibrahim, we have a tweet from Liberté_info kind of arguing your point, echoing what you're saying the book clearly tries to amalgamate different terms like terrorist, Muslim, extremist, and also the word crazy, which is not mentioned in this tweet. And then we have a tweet from MG Huff saying, does the book have any positive images of Muslims? Or mention that Muslims died that day too? And perhaps that's the larger question. Now, 10,000 copies have already been sold, which is, I think it's sold out, and it's now going to its second print. So what is your main concern in terms of trying to maybe do something as part of CARE to reverse the perception that this book is releasing?
Well, one concern is that we're giving this guy a bunch of free publicity, unfortunately. But we do educational efforts all the time. We have around the country, we have more than 30 chapters who are doing 9/11 commemorative events, panel discussions, interfaith activities, educational outreach activities, as are other Muslim groups and Muslim communities around the nation. As you mentioned, let's not forget that more than 30 Muslims died in the Twin Towers. There were Muslim first responders. If you go to our website, cair.com, you can find some public service announcements, videos featuring Muslim first responders to the 9/11 attacks. None of this obviously is shown in this agenda-driven coloring book.
Ibrahim, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
Now, remember, you can actually read more about this story and others right on our website, stream.aljazeera.com.